internet is changing the way we're consuming our sports coverage. As you guys know, you no longer have to go to mainstream news outlet to get the same old boring quote. Alana G works for Yardbarker, a website that gives you coverage like none other. She also happens to be one of the leading bloggers in the nation.
Oh, she's star studded there. She's doing big things, so it's a good thing.
She looks like a celebrity.
She is a celebrity. So when people meet you for the first time and they hear what you do for a living, what's the most common reaction you get?
That's cool.
Alana's great. She's Yardbarker all through and through. Always working. She helped get me out here, so yo, mad props to Alana.
She holds it down.
I be in Atlanta still, chilling, watching like T-Bone episodes of Lost if I was not here.
What would you tell people who want to get started and become a blogger, a sports blogger?
They gotta get a blog, either a blog or if you want to do video, you gotta get your own YouTube channel, and you can't wait for somebody to put you on, and you can't wait for somebody to pay you to do something. Just get your own blog started, and hopefully you can get traffic and get noticed from there, and then maybe make something of it. But that's how I got started. I just started a blog, and I wasn't even trying to do anything with it.
What do I think about her? She's doing a good job. I think she definitely in everybody's place to get a story, which is a good thing, because she's on the grind. She's doing her thing.
And what's it like to interview these athletes? Because most people don't have access to them, and you do this for a living. So what's that? I mean, you take it for granted almost?
I mean, to me, it's just regular people. I mean, I think the very first interview I ever did with an athlete was Lisa Leslie, and I was completely starstruck because she's amazing to me, and the entire interview, I was just stuttering, and I couldn't even get through it. And then after her, I just realized, with everybody else, they're just regular people. They're just, young kids for the most part. I'm like 10 years older than a lot of them, so you just relax and you talk to them like a regular person.
Ladies, really quick, what do you think about Alana G, who just interviewed you?
Oh my gosh, she's gorgeous!
She's sexy.
Look how hot she is.
I don't know if this is a compliment or a slur, but they say you're like a female version of me.
I'll take that as a compliment.
So, what's been some of your best moments with these athletes? Can you give me a couple examples?
I think some of the best moments, when we met with Rasheed Wallace for Yardbarker, he was great all around, gave us a lot of good videos, good material, and he was just a funny guy, and I hadn't known what to expect because a bunch of people had warned me. They said, hey, a lot of people in Detroit said he doesn't like talking to the media, he's going to be mean, he's not gonna react to you, but he was real friendly. He did good, so that was a good moment. I think talking to Donovan McNabb at Super Bowl, that was great because he had just come off the set from ESPN. He had been on SportsCenter, and we kind of grabbed him in a corner, and there was fans all around. They were screaming his name, and we actually got a little 5-minute interview with him, so that was great.
She's looking nice. Got a nice look.
Everybody thinks she's Alicia Keys all weekend.
Really?
Yeah, we got Alicia Keys.
She reminds me of Alicia Keys.
We should strip her down. We should strip her down. I know.
Alicia Keys.
Take it. Oh, damn.
Work it.
Alicia Keys? She's been hearing that too.
She almost does regularly. Yeah.
There have been a couple moments when, I've been talking to somebody, we've been joking around, talking about something funny, and then the publicist or the agent comes by and tries to cut it off because they don't like the direction that I'm going. And that's always tough to deal with, but, you just move on. You cut that footage and you don't use it because it's not worth it. And you just have to take those as they come.
Now, Alana, did you ever think that this internet, when you started your blog, will replace newspapers, take the place of TV and radio as the source where people go to get their sports news?
I think that's been a long time coming. Newspapers have been on the decline for a while, and that's just the new way people are using media these days. It's inevitable, but it has definitely come a very long way, even just since I've been in this last couple of years, since 2006 or so.
It's cool. Yardbarker.com. I just heard about it today, so I'm gonna log on today. As soon as I get to the hotel, I'm going to Yardbarker.com.
Hey, on the real, I feel you're funny enough that you need to have a blog. You ever blog or anything like that?
No, I never did nothing.
One more note about Alana. After hanging around her for 3 days, watching her interact with people, I have to tell you, she's one of the most eligible bachelorettes I've ever been around. So make sure to check out Yardbarker and, of course, AlanaG.com. In Los Angeles, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.